To the Love Below, and I have with me you guys, Corey Holcomb.
What up, y'all?
Hey, Corey.
What's up? How you doing?
So good. Let me tell you, it's so interesting having you on here, because Corey, listening to your set, you don't like nobody.
I like people. I just don't like them after it's over.
You don't like them after it's over.
Yeah, that's why I pay. I'll be like, baby, I gave you money, you can fuck out of it. That feel good. Sometimes they wind up pregnant. That's why I always keep one of these out of town. That was a joke.
Listen, you just unhinging that, going on a bit.
Oh, yeah, I know how to find it.
What you numb them up with?
I don't numb them up, goddamn it.
Just got
it costs money to go buy that medicine. I be like, you want me to buy the medicine or give you the money for the numbing medicine? They be like, I ain't taking money.
There you have it, folks. So, what is most important about sex to you?
Hoping that I'm with somebody that ain't got nothing, because I gamble.
So what you want to do is make sure you use some condoms or something. You
condoms
know?
Take away from what's happening. We are risking our lives in the name of booty callness or whatever. No, I wear condoms according to how you look, goddammit.
So hold on now, because cute bitches can yield some ugly little motherfuckers. Now, don't get it twisted.
I believe you, but if the inside of your purse look nasty, I always wear rubber with you.
Inside of the purse, ladies.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to keep your shit clean fucking with this nigga.
That's right.
So what you name is, check your purse.
Some girls have nasty purses. That means there's something wrong with them, goddammit. And their kids come out with disorder. I don't want no baby crying like this.
So, what would be your best piece of sex advice?
Best piece of sex advice for the ladies or the fellas?
You know what? Let's start with the fellas.
Okay, the best piece of sex advice is to fuck girls from third world countries. They don't have child support in places like Ghana and shit like that.
And for the women?
For the women, fuck with people that don't give a fuck about you, and you gotta know they don't give a fuck about you. That's where your expectations are low, and you can wind up like your mama.
So have you ever gone into the sex with real high expectations and still been let down?
No, I don't believe in nobody. When I was young, I used to believe in women, but trial and error has showed me that everybody that let me fuck them must not give a fuck about themselves.
Must not. I'm trying to tell you, after you be around him for a few minutes, ladies, and you still
want to
fuck him, you ambitious like shit.
That's true. She's a prophet.
Like shit. He already told you,
you
ain't gonna get nothing. He already told you, he
said
you bad, so you give him $40 for the plan B?
No, I give him more than $40 nowadays. $40 was like one of my original jokes. I do a lot more for him because $40 don't go nowhere. I give a bitch $65.
There you go. What's that for?
To help them get on their feet and take that Uber home. Because when they come off their car, they fuck their shit up for the week. A lot of bitches work at Jack in the Box. And $25, that's real paper to a Jack in the Box bitch.
So, being as though you're in entertainment,
getting
a lot of pussy, y'all. Thomas, anything that's still taboo to you about sex? Anything that's still, you know,
gosh. Yeah, taboo. I never get in a bitch car. I don't give a fuck if I got a motherfucking jog home. I ain't getting no car with no woman. Because they always set you up. There's a nigga that love that bitch following y'all. And you going to wind up fighting.
All right, man. He ain't getting in the car. But he checking your purse. And if you see him with this motherfucking hanger, you better watch your back, bitches.
Pull it out. You feel it. Like when the hanger twirl, you feel that little hard shit. Then you lift up and go down. Yeah. And that motherfucker be on that hanger like a fish.
Shit on the mummy and they stuck
like
it
a little baby bluegill.
Terrible.
This is how they be, goddamn it. Pull that hanger, you feel it, yank it down, goddamn it. Oh, there you go.
First, visual, okay, you guys, on
come
the
come come out like this.
Poor baby. Poor baby. It's all Corey Holcomb's kids on the floor.
This interview going viral, man.
Hilarious. Thank good. You so much for being on the Love for Love. I appreciate it.
That's what's up.
For people who don't know or don't know how to follow you, tell them how to follow you.
Just Google Corey Holcomb 5150 Show and let the adventure begin. And you know what I'm saying? I want to say all of the single moms out there.
There's nothing to be said, okay? Watch your motherfucking back. Keep your coochies in your purse clothes, okay? If you gonna fuck with this nigga, hey, you a playing C, D, and E. This nigga ain't shit. Okay, don't nobody want that, hang on. Don't nobody want that. But thank you guys for watching The Love Below. It's so much more to come. Season 2 is wrapping up, you guys. Season 3 is about to be popping. Don't want to miss it.